Last week, astronomers were talking about some pretty extreme planets, so let's start with one that sounds like it comes straight out of Greek mythology. Like a god eating its children, there is a star that seems to be eating a huge gas planet that orbits it. The star is called PTFO 8-8695, and it's about 1100 light-years away from Earth. Its planet, PTFO 8-8695b, was first suggested from data done by a survey back in 2012, but astronomers needed more evidence before they could be confident that a planet was actually there. They were specifically skeptical because the star is only about 2 or 3 million years old, around 1/1000th the age of the Sun. Planets around such young stars are pretty rare, and when they are found, they're usually far away from the star. But this planet is an example of a hot Jupiter, a gas giant orbiting very close to its home star that can be anywhere from the size and mass of Saturn to more than 10 times as massive as Jupiter. This planet, for example, is probably around 2 times Jupiter's mass and seems to complete an orbit once every 11 hours, so its year is half as long as our day. That's really short, and it puts the planet incredibly close to its star, close enough that PTFO 8-8695 might actually be able to steal gas from the atmosphere of the planet, according to one group of astronomers whose study was accepted by the Astrophysical Journal last week. They came to this surprising conclusion after using telescopes in Texas and Arizona to study light emitted by the planet and the star. When hydrogen gas is really energized, one of the wavelengths of light it can emit is in the red side of the visible spectrum, also called H-alpha emissions. And the astronomers found the H-alpha emissions from the planet's outer atmosphere were almost as bright as the emissions from the star itself. Now, hot Jupiters can typically get as hot as a couple thousand Kelvin, but the hydrogen atoms in their atmosphere should not have as much energy as the atoms in a nearby star. So the astronomers think that the gas in the planet's atmosphere could be interacting with the star's stellar wind, the stream of charged particles constantly flowing off its surface. And because of this, the gas could be escaping the planet's gravity and then getting trapped by the star's gravity and pulled to the star's surface. It's possible that the entire atmosphere could eventually get stripped off like this, leaving a sad remnant of a world, or maybe an equilibrium will be reached someday. Only time will tell. The astronomers admit that there are other explanations for some of their data, like extreme sunspots or a ring of dust around the star. But they do think that planet eating is the most likely cause. And now let's turn from killing planets to forming them. Our Sun is thought to be a third-generation star, meaning that it formed from the ashes of stars that formed from the ashes of the first stars that coalesced after the Big Bang created the universe. By the time the Sun was born, there were lots of heavier elements in the cosmos, elements like aluminum and silicon and iron, which make up a lot of the Earth's crust. But in a lot of second-generation stars, there weren't as many of these heavier elements, since they are made in the cores of dying stars, and only one generation of stars had come and gone. Some of these stars without many heavy elements are called carbon-enhanced metal-poor stars, or CEMP stars. As their name suggests, CEMP stars also have a pretty high percentage of carbon. And last week, a pair of researchers at Harvard showed for the first time that planets can and probably did form around these CEMP stars, and they could have been some of the first planets to form in the universe. Because of all the carbon around, these planets would have been like gigantic lumps of graphite or diamond, depending on the conditions when they formed. There are still some CEMP stars around the Milky Way that we can study, so we can look for these carbon-rich, elusive remnants of the very early universe. And here's the thing, interspersed with all of the carbon in CEMP stars are elements like oxygen and hydrogen. And those elements are some of the most important elements for life on Earth. So that raises the exciting possibility that these planets might not have just been the first planets in the universe, but they could have been the first places in the entire universe where life formed. Now all we have to do is find some to study. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow Space News, especially to all of our patrons on Patreon who make this show possible, allow us to talk about all this cool stuff for you. If you want to be one of those people and maybe get some cool stuff, you can go to patreon.com/scishow. And if you just want to keep learning about the universe with us, you can go to youtube.com/scishowspace and subscribe. Atmosphere maybe once or twice a month. Lots of these objects burn up over water, and they aren't dangerous even when they do fly over inhabited land. The one above Arizona, for example, probably disintegrated around 35 kilometers.